And welcome back to The Morning Blend with our pet project. If you feel strongly about animal welfare, there are a few ways that you can make a lasting impact for the years to come.
Lynn Olenek is the executive director at Humane Animal Welfare Society, or HAWS. She is here with information on how to show your love through legacy giving, and she brought along Rolly.
Rolly is so cute.
What is your deal? Available for adoption?
Yes, his litter mates all went home.
What?
He was the one that was left.
Why were you left behind? You're so sweet.
He's just so cute.
Oh, we lost your microphone.
Yeah,
we lost
your microphone. Here, let me see if I can help with you. There.
I can't see. Here's the cord. Go from the cord.
Oh, go from the cord.
Go from the cord. Okay.
Oh, yep.
So Rolly's available, and we'll let it. We'll get your cord first. There we go.
There we go. Okay, I got it. Okay, I'm so sorry.
Thank you, Rolly, for your help.
Yeah.
Rolly, you were good.
Rolly poly.
There you go, Lynn. I'm sorry about that.
So Rolly's available for adoption, and all by himself. Mm-hmm. And what kind of home would he be good in, do you think?
He would go anywhere. Yeah. I mean, he's just a doll. I would be a little concerned with him with toddler age kids that might step on him or whatever. These little skinny legs.
I know.
I think he's a rat terrier chihuahua cross.
Yeah.
He's not going to be big. He's only 8 pounds now, 12 weeks. So 20 pounds by the time he's all done, I would think.
Yeah.
So, you know, and I brought him for a reason. I'm 60. Mm-hmm. Say I would get this dog now. He's going to live until I'm 8, you know, in maybe 18 years.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be 78 if I would adopt him. I need to have a plan for how to care for him, which would be setting up a pet trust.
Okay.
But in addition to that, people who love animals leave finances to HAWS or other organizations, or maybe Children's Hospital is close to you or one of the colleges. Those help us satisfy our dreams.
Yeah.
So having money left to us to help get an education program going with Carroll University.
Yeah.
Having money left to us to help expand a program. Having money left to help build a training room.
Yeah.
And that's what legacy giving is, right?
Yes.
And do you specify certain things?
That you want the money to go to?
Yeah, donor-directed giving is getting more popular. People like to know where their money's going. Mm-hmm. I had a volunteer who passed away who was real active with our small animals, mm-hmm. and she left her funds so that we could upgrade small animal housing in the future when we needed it. Mm-hmm. And that money's put in a special spot and saved for the time when we would need it. So directed giving is getting to be very popular. But even younger people, you can leave a portion of your 401k.
Yeah.
You know, otherwise, when you go, where's it going to go? Maybe your parents don't need that money.
Right.
You know, so in thinking ahead about your own pets, and then thinking ahead about building a legacy for things to come with the funds that you've worked hard for throughout your life. Now, there's going to be people who don't have anything left over. That's unfortunate.
Yeah.
But there are a lot of people who have funds.
So how does an individual go about doing that? What do you do? Because I know that money that you talked about for the companion circle really helped there at HAWS as well. So how in turn can somebody who's hearing this say, I want to do that. I want to leave even $100, whatever it may be.
You just earmark it on your forms, work with your financial planners or with your HR departments at work, and just set up either a percentage. A lot of people who have children will leave, you know, a quarter to each of their three kids and a quarter to a charity of choice.
Yep.
Whether it's an animal charity or it's some other charity, these funds are so important because we don't budget for them.
Yeah.
They allow us to do above and beyond.
Well, and I think it sets such a good example for your children. So you share with them, that's great. But to also show your kids that what your life was about was also giving to the sweet little things in our community that really need our help too. So I appreciate you talking about this great subject. I want to make sure that people have information about leaving a legacy of love for little pets in our community and big pets too. HAWS, hawspets.org, and you can call 262-542-8851 to learn more. And you can log on to the hawspets.org website too and click on bequests, right? And other gifts too for helpful hints on exactly how to go about giving that way.
And give Rolly a good home.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Available for adoption. Thank you so much, Lynn. We appreciate your time.
Thank you.